बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल एंड यू आर वॉचिंग द वीडियोज़ एंड सॉल्विंग योर असाइनमेंट्स योर सेल्फ। स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ परसेंटेज एंड वी हैव डिस्कस द प्रोसीजर्स ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, 2 एंड 3। होपफुली यू हैव फिनिश्ड योर दैट असाइनमेंट एंड यू विल बी रेडी फॉर योर टूडेज असाइनमेंट। स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, 2 एंड 3। इन टूडेज वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द प्रोसीजर ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, 5 एंड 6 एंड 7, राइट? सो लेट्स सी योर क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 फर्स्ट। एक्सप्रेस ईच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग डेसिमल्स एज अ परसेंटेज। स्टूडेंट्स, सी इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 यू हैव टू एक्सप्रेस ईच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग फ्रैक्शंस एज अ परसेंटेज। नाउ इन दिस यू हैव टू एक्सप्रेस ईच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग डेसिमल्स एज अ परसेंटेज। बोथ क्वेश्चंस आर सेम, फ्रैक्शन टू परसेंटेज, डेसिमल टू परसेंटेज। द डिफरेंस इज जस्ट इन दिस यू वर हैविंग फ्रैक्शंस एंड इन दिस क्वेश्चन यू आर हैविंग डेसिमल नंबर। व्हाट्स द प्रोसीजर वी हैव यूज्ड इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 3? व्हेन यू नीड टू कन्वर्ट a fraction into a percentage, you need to multiply it with 100%. Why we have multiplied with 100%? Because 100% is always equal to 100 out of 100. And when you have same numerator and denominator, your answer is always equal to 1. Right? So, the same procedure, multiplying with 100%, we are going to use for our next question because both are the same. Just we have difference of fraction and decimal number. So let's start our question number 4. Okay, in our question number 4, we have 0.78%. 0.78% is a decimal number. Students, in the multiplication with 10, 100 and 1000 is easy, but it's a little bit tricky. Why? Because you need to remember where you have to shift your decimal point, to the right hand side or to the left hand side. It always creates a confusion. To avoid that confusion, I'm going to use this method. In this method, we will convert this decimal number into a fraction. As you can see, we have two decimal places, 1 and 2. So, when you will convert it into a fraction, you will write two zeros with one in the denominator, right? When you will have two decimal places, that means you have divided with 100, right? This is the conversion of decimal number to fraction. This is the thing you have already learned in your grade 4 and 5, right? So I'm not going into detail. Just what you have to do, when you have a decimal number, you need to count your decimal places. If you have two decimal places, you need to write two zeros in the denominator. And if you have three decimal places, you need to write three zeros in the denominator. Right? Now, like your question number 3, I have converted your decimal number into a fraction. Now, you can see these two are in the same form. Right? What we have done previously, to convert this fraction into a percentage, I have multiplied it with 100%. So same thing I'll do here. I'll multiply your fraction with 100%. Right? And as I have told you earlier that the denominator is always a divisor. It can divide your numerators. Right? Your numerator and your multiplier. Right? We can do the simplification or cancellation in the numerator and denominator. Right? Because these two are the even numbers. Both are divisible by 2. But I'll do it with 100 because it will make our procedure very easier. How we can do that? If you have zeros, the cancellation of zeros are very easy. Just count the equal number of zeros and cancel them. Two zeros with two zeros, because these two are on the opposite sides. One was in the denominator and one was in the multiplier, right? If you will have the zeros in the same side, then you cannot do this cancellation. Or you can do it like this, 100 ones are 100 and 100 ones are 100. 100. So we are left with 78 over zeros are cancelled, 1 multiply by only 1%, right? So 78 ones are 78, and 78 over 1 is equal to 78. And don't forget to write your percentage symbol, because we need our answer in percentage. Hopefully you have understood the procedure of both the questions. Okay. The next thing we are going to do, we are going to solve our question number 5. Our question number 5 is find the value of each of the following. Students, the difference between your question number 4 and 5, in your question number 4 you are calculating percentage, and in your question number 5 you need to find the value. When you are calculating the value, you will not write your percentage symbol in the answer, right? Okay, the first part we have to do is 50% of $70. 50%, how we can convert this percentage into a fraction? First, 50% means 50 out of 100. For of, we always use multiply symbol or sign, right? And $70 as it is. As I have told you that cancellation of zeros are very easy, just you need to count the equal number of zeros. Now you can see we have 10 in the 70, so we can cancel 10 with 10 in 100. Again, 50 and 10 are on the opposite sides. One is in the numerator and one is in the denominator. So we can also cancel them. We have 10 in 10 and we have 10 in 50. So cancel them. And we are left with 5 over 1 multiply by, no, not 70, only $7, right? 5 sevens are 35, and 35 over 1 is 35. So the value of 50% of $70 is $35. That means 50% of 70. 50% means half of 70, and you can also check your answer by dividing 70 into 2 equal parts. If you have 70 rupees and you are dividing it in 2 friends, then obviously you will have 35 and 35. Understood? Okay, now let's discuss question number 6. As it's a word problem, so students, you need to do it very carefully. How we will do that? First, we will try to understand the statement and we will write the given points first, right? There are 20 boys. How many boys? 20 boys. So first thing given is number of boys, and number of boys is 20, right? The second given thing is, and 18 girls in a class, number of girls. How many girls we have? 18. So students, first thing we need to know, how many total students we have. So your total students ...20 plus 18, yes, it's 38 students. Understood? Okay, now let's see what we have to calculate. Find, what we have to find out, the percentage of boys and girls in the class, right? So first we will calculate the percentage of boys. Percentage of boys. Students, you will find the percentage of boys. How you will do that? You will divide number of boys in the class with total students in the class, and as it's a fraction, and how we have converted a fraction into a decimal percentage, how we have converted a fraction into a percentage? By multiplying it with 100%. So same thing we will do here. 20 over 38, number of boys, over total students in the class, multiply it with 100%. Right? You can do the simplification yourself. We have already done this thing, so I will not do the solution for you. Right? You have to do it yourself. In the same way, you can find out the percentage of girls. How many girls you have? 18 girls and 38 total students. So you will write again percentage of girls, 18 over 38 multiply by 100%, and you need to do the solution, remaining solution yourself. Hope you can do that. Let's move to the last question we have done in this exercise, is your question number 7. Your question number 7 is again a word problem. So first we will write the given information, then we will solve our sum. There are 120 cars. How many cars? 120 cars in a multi-story car park. So first thing, we will write number of cars. Number of cars. We have 120 cars, right? Then, given that 30% of them are blue. How many cars are blue? 30%. It's not the number, it's the percentage. So we will write percentage of blue cars, and that's equal to 30%. Right? Okay. The next thing, what we have to find out, find the number of cars which are not blue. You have to find out the number, not the percentage. Because the percentage of blue cars is given, we need to find out the number of cars which are not blue. So, first, we need to judge what's the percentage of not blue cars. What's the percentage of cars which are not blue? What's the total percentage we always have? Yes, you are right. We always have 100%, right? So, from 100%, 30% of the cars are blue. So, what would be the percentage of cars which are not blue? Yes, which are not blue. Obviously, from 100, if 30% are blue, then obviously 70% are not blue. Right? Understood? Now, you need to find the number of cars. Number of cars which are not blue. Students, as we know, the percentage of cars which are not blue, that is 70%. How many total cars we have? 120. That means 70% of 120 cars are not blue, right? Then 70% of 120, right? You need to calculate this thing, and that you have done this procedure. We have done this in your question number 5. So complete this answer yourself. This is your today's assignment. In your today's assignment, what you have to do, you have to solve the remaining parts of your question number 4 and your question number 5. Right? I have done only one part for you. The remaining parts you will do of your question number 4 and your question number 5. Then you will complete your question number 6 and your question number 7. Right? Hopefully you have understood the procedures of the questions. I'll share the picture of the assignment in your WhatsApp group or on LMS. Try to solve the assignments yourself. And I'm saying again and again, please don't copy it from your notebooks. It's for your revision. It's the preparation of your exam. So try to solve it at your own. If you face any difficulty, then you can take the help from your elder one or from your notebook, but don't copy from your notebooks. Thank you. Take care. Allah Hafiz.